I can get crazy as hell sometimes. I finally, I'm in this zone. It's showtime! Hello and welcome back to my channel. My name is Carissa. If you don't know me, now you do. I'm a full-time model and I'm currently in isolation in Philadelphia in a beautiful Airbnb, hence the crazy wallpaper but beautiful windows in this Airbnb. And I thought, I did a hair tutorial on this, which I will link below this video. And I was like, if I'm gonna do a Kendall Jenner hair tutorial, why not also do a makeup tutorial on the same day and combine them? Boom, major Kendall Jenner realness. This makeup look in particular was done by Mary Phillips. I'm obsessed with it. I think it came out really good. I shot this once before and didn't love the way it turned out, so I reshot it. And this time I'm actually loving it. And if you wanna see how I got this look, please keep watching. I already did my skincare routine, which I just filmed and I will link that below or above, wherever I can figure out where to put it. So I will go right into putting on Aquaphor on my lips. I'm gonna use the Mario Badescu aloe spray. Aloe, cucumber, and green tea. It just kind of like wets your face and I feel like makes my foundation go on better. I'm using the Maybelline Fit Me Dewy and Smooth SPF 18, and it is in color 120 Classic Ivory. I think it's super important to keep on blending, keep on pouncing it into your skin if you're using a beauty blender, because it just makes it look more natural and shears it down a little bit. I think my opinion, the least amount of cakey coverage, the better. I like a really natural face, especially with doing anything involving like a supermodel or a model look, because they tend to look very natural. And being a model myself, I don't like to wear a lot of makeup on my face because I feel like it makes me look older. I can always go back and add a little bit more on my cheeks because they tend to shear down first for some reason. A little rosacea there that comes through. But don't worry, this is not all the coverage we're gonna do. My next step, I like to do all my cream products at the same time. So my next step will be concealer. I use two different types of concealer. My first one is the same shade as my foundation, and it is in 2W Light Medium Estee Lauder Double Wear. And with this one, I will use it anywhere on my face that looks, I don't know, just like it needs a little bit of extra coverage. Not really anywhere I want to highlight, just anywhere I still want to cover. I really like the wear of this concealer. Give you a little bit more coverage exactly where you need it instead of all over every ounce of your face. My next concealer will be a lighter shade, and it's Glossier Stretch Concealer in shade G11. This is very dewy. I like to take a brush. Any flat brush is fine, flat concealer brush. And I'm going to highlight in this zone. I like to do it here so it pulls my face back up into kind of like the same way the ponytail does. A little bit of a facelift, so I'll go. And then I'll put a little bit right here, center of the forehead, just to highlight it a bit. And maybe a little bit right in the center of my nose. And then, same beauty blender, blend it out. I like using the same beauty blender for all the concealer and the foundation because I feel like it makes it look more seamless. Fun fact, I filmed this yesterday, and the entire time I had something stuck in my tooth. So I had to refilm it, but that's okay because I decided to do it a little bit differently, and I didn't really like my coverage yesterday in person. So I think that this looks a lot better actually today. And your skin prep is very important for that, so don't discount a great moisturizer, an eye cream, and a little face massage before you put on your makeup. Continuing with the creams, I will now go in with my contour shade, and it's from Milani. It's a cheap version, but it's contour and highlight in the shade Natural Medium. It kind of looks like the Kim Kardashian contour stick, except, you know, way cheaper. I like to contour where I already see the shadow, so I pretty much just like to emphasize what's already there instead of creating a face shape that doesn't exist. And I take it in a little bit further because I really like it to look cinched in. And this is just for my face shape. Your face shape might be different, and that's totally fine. But spend time and learn your face shape so that you know where it looks best on you, because it's totally opinion-based. I only do it there because I have a very wide nose in the center, and I really don't like to make it look super thin. It's just not my jam. Push that back a little bit. I'll put a little bit underneath my jawline just to pop it a little bit underneath. Someone told me to put it underneath the jaw so that it, do you see it already looks like, I didn't blend it out yet, but it creates a better shadow than putting it on the jaw in the front. Now I will take my Sigma F05 small contour brush and blend very lightly, very light hand. I'm a model and I learn a lot from different makeup artists, and another makeup artist told me to hold the brush closer to the end if you want to be lighter. Because you know I can get crazy as hell sometimes. I really like it underneath the jawline. Just make sure you do that weird double chin thing and it'll blend it in. I'll go back in and finish my nose with a smaller brush. See, I like how it brings the shadow down here. Honestly, being on camera for a lot of years has taught me a lot about angles and my own personal face. And it really doesn't matter unless you're a makeup artist or some kind of visual artist. What everyone else's face looks like, it only really matters what yours looks like. So you might love a trend, a makeup trend, or a style, but learn your own face. It is priceless information, and you'll be able to do your own makeup better than anybody because you spend hours a day, or hours, you know, every time you're doing your makeup, just staring, analyzing, and deciding what looks best for you. Not everybody wants a super thin nose. Not everybody wants the same thing. So you make up in your mind what you think is beautiful on you. Don't let somebody else tell you what to do with your face. Like, that's enough contouring for my nose. I don't need it to look like a Michael Jackson, it doesn't exist kind of nose. That's not really my vibe. You can still add cream on top of cream, but once you start going powder, it's hard to go back to the cream. So just make sure, because the next step is going to be powders, and you do not want to keep layering powder, cream, and blend the under eye, the lids, and around the nose, because those are the areas I'm going to set right now. I'm going to use my Laura Mercier translucent powder and just a little fluffy brush. I think this is e.l.f. Like, you can use any fluffy brush under the eye. For around my nose, I'm gonna use a smaller version of this brush from e.l.f. just to really get in there, because my nose tends to crease right there a lot. And then the lid. And then I will set in between my eyes because I like the size of this brush for this area. I hate when powder gets all in my brows. I would rather just not correct it. I'd rather just not get it in there. Do you know what I'm saying? It's like so many people get powder all over their dang face and then go in and correct it for hours. Like, how about no? How about we just don't get it in there in the first place? Do you know what I'm saying? We will go back in and finish the powders once we do the eye. So I'm going to do the shadows on the eye, the mascara. I like to, for some reason, at the very end, contour, highlight, blush at the end. So that's what we'll do. Let's move on to brows. I haven't been to my brow girl in a very long time, so they're a little crazy, but I'm not touching them. I'm using this time to let them grow and let her do her magic when I get back. I will survive. So I'm going to go in with Glossier Boy Brow. Wow, it's a really awkward time to have allergies. I'm going to go in with Glossier Boy Brow and just brush them upwards. Okay, I just brush them up as much as possible because they're always gonna fall a little bit. So my first go around, a little crazy, all the way up. The second thing I use in my brows, I've really figured like out how my brows look good and I feel really good about this combo. I have this Anastasia Beverly Hills Brow Mascara in dark brown, and very, very lightly on my hairs, I go over, create a little bit more depth. It's kind of like a brow mascara, but you know, especially with this dark brown color, you have to be very light-handed because I've had a few times where I've done my whole base, put this on, and then had to restart because it looked like Groucho Marx. But it definitely gives it a more natural look. I'm not into like Instagram brows, it's not my vibe. And this picture of Kendall, she has very natural brushed up model brows, so that's already what I like, so we're just gonna continue that vibe. I do fill them in a little bit, especially now because my shape is jacked up. Hi Tara, if you're watching this, I cannot wait to see you. I'm going to use Anastasia Beverly Hills Dark Brown Dip Brow Pomade with a It Cosmetics Build-A-Brow Brush, my favorite brow brush I've ever used. I'm going to warm it up into the lid. I always do this. My brow girl told me this is the proper way to use it, so ever since I've been doing this, they do look way better, way more natural. And then once I get the right amount of product, I will start drawing little strokes where it looks sparse. I do not outline the whole thing. I don't like that. I just like drawing my own fake hairs. I have a little bit more trouble with this brow, because right here always gives me an ish. But that's all right. We're gonna make it work. They're sisters, not twins. I feel like we all have to repeat that to ourselves every time we do our brows because we all panic. It's really hard to see in the camera if they're even. I'm kind of far from the mirror. I have this other trick I use when I'm doing my makeup to see if I've gone too far. And this is like one of my favorite things to do. I'm telling you this works. Take out your camera on your iPhone or whatever phone you have and look at yourself in this camera and you will be able to see immediately what's wrong. So I don't really like the way this looks right here, right under there. This one always tends to look a little bit I'm happy with that. So now we'll move on to the eyeshadow, which will be amazing because I love this look so much. So let me grab the picture one more time. This is the photo that we're trying to recreate. And that's how orange. So yesterday when I did this look, I don't think I did it orange enough. It was pretty and it was more wearable, but it wasn't really this. So I have a different method I'm gonna use today. And also looking at this, her lips are contoured. Let me do that before we start eyes. They're like huge on contouring her lips. I think she has lip injections also, but they look really nice. And they definitely contour her lips. So I'm gonna use the same contour shade I used on my face. I'm going to go around my lips as if it's lip liner, like overline it, and then blend it out. And then a little bit over top. So you kind of look like a little wild. That's all right. It creates a shadow around your lips, creating a bigger pout. We'll just blend it out. I think this is too big. I'm gonna use this small e.l.f. brush. I think it creates more of a shadow, like it's so big that it's falling over my lip. Nice little contour trick. Thank you, Mary Phillips. And I did forget to set the bottom half of my face. I like to do this with my translucent powder to make my jawbone come out a little bit, snatch me a little bit. I take a good amount of the powder on the flat edge and I drag it from mid ear to corner of mouth. And then I'll leave it as I do my eye makeup and then dust it off at the end. I feel like it helps cut this in because when I dust it off later, you can still see a little bit of the lightness. I'm gonna leave that on there. Look like a marionette. Look like a damn marionette. Put down a little bit of a blending shade in my crease. She doesn't have a lot going up above her crease, but a little bit. There's a little bit of a transitional shade in the crease. So I'm going to start with something not quite as pigmented as the lid shade, and it's gonna be from the Kylie palette. Please excuse the mess here. The Kylie palette, it's the middle color, the orange one. This is the bronze palette. I'm gonna take a fluffy brush, Sigma E40 tapered brush, and just put it in the crease. And I tend to see where my eyebrow ends. I feel like you should put your shadow all the way out to here. So I am gonna put it, it gives your eye more of this shape, like a triangle going towards your hairline, which I like. Oh, you know what? Same thing on the other side. I feel like it's really hard to mess up eyeshadow. Just do a little bit at a time and just keep going back and forth. So yesterday I said I didn't think I did it vibrant enough on my lid. So I'm gonna try something different today. I'm going to take this white pencil from NYX, 906 white, and I'm going to warm it up on my hand. Maybe add a little bit of, ooh, a little bit of setting spray here. Just warm it up really good. Because I don't want to pull my lid. Because what I'm going to do is put it on my lid as a little bit of a base to the orange. So that the orange looks, and then blend it up with my finger. So that the orange looks more vibrant. Because I don't really have a neon orange. And I'm only putting the white to the crease, so just on my lid. That really lightens up the eyelid. It's also kind of like color by numbers, because now you see exactly where to put the bright orange. And she does have a little bit of orange, less than I put on yesterday under her eye. Now that I'm looking at it, it's very small pop. So I'm going to put a little small pop of white under my eye so that I can keep it smaller and still have it be visible. So right here. And it makes it a little sticky, so I think it's gonna stick to it a lot better than it did yesterday. I am taking this Galaxy Chic palette. It's the only one I have that has these vibrant colors in it. It's from BH Cosmetics, and I'm using the Mars color right there. Flat brush, where are you? Flat brush. I swear sometimes you be doing your makeup and the shit's right in front of you and you don't even see it. Okay, I'm taking this Dior number 2 flat brush. You can use any flat brush you have. It does not have to be Dior. I'm taking the orange. I'm putting a lot on there, tapping off the excess so it doesn't get on my skin. And I'm just going to start placing it over the white. This is really vibrant, and this is way more the vibe. Yes, that looks awesome. Oh, I actually love this shade. Okay. And then I'm gonna do the same thing to the other lid. Wow, that looks dope. Once you feel like you have enough of the orange on, which I'm like, is there ever enough of this color? Damn, this is dope. Then I'm gonna take that brush we just used with the Kylie color and just go into the crease and just blend that so it doesn't look any, no harsh lines. Try right under the lash line like the photo and try to get this little pop of orange that's right underneath of her eye. This little number 24 brush by Dior, very small. And I'm going to take that same orange, get my magnifying glass, because you know I can't see that far. And I'm just going to pop it right here. So I'm going to add a little liner because her eyes are so almond shaped that in order to get the same vibe, I think I'm gonna do a little bit of liner in the corner to kind of make it more sharp this way. And then maybe just a little bit to bring my eye more up using my Marc Jacobs liner and an angled brush. I'm going to just pick up a little bit of that. Okay, so I like that it gave me more of this shape. I'm now going to do a little bit of tight lining on the top lash line. So I'm just gonna take what's left over on this and add a little bit of darkness to emphasize the eye shape. Just gives it a little bit more definition on the eyes. I'm not going to do fake eyelashes because I just don't love them on me, probably because I can't do them correctly. So I'm just going to curl my lashes with this Revlon eyelash curler and then do a lot of mascara. Hypnose Drama from Lancome. Let's brush off the powder with my Anastasia Beverly Hills Contour Kit in light to medium. I'm going to powder contour my face, and I literally do all the bottom shades. Just no regard. No regard. Picking up the Coco Collection by Kylie Cosmetics palette. Love this bronzer, clearly, it's almost gone. Going to use that with a big fluffy brush. She doesn't really look like she has a cheek color, does she? But she definitely has some highlight right here. Like in this zone. And I might put a touch of blush because it's a little bit pink, but not too much. So let's start with a little bit of blush. going to use this shade because it's the only one I have on me and just tap it and pat it off because it's a little pinker than hers. And I'm gonna hit it right here on the apples. The Benefit Cookie Highlighter. It's like my favorite highlighter lately. It looks so sparkly, but it does not look sparkly on your face. And this brush by Doll 10 called the Prepping Perfector. And I'm gonna add a little bit of highlighter right in this zone. Now I'm going to take, since her lip looks pretty matte, I think I'm just gonna layer a bunch of different things that are similar to her color. And these Marc Jacobs lip liners are the best lip liners I've ever used. I'm obsessed, and I have it in Nudist and Primrose. Nudist is my favorite by far, especially if you like to overline your lips a little bit. Start with that. I'm gonna put on a little bit of the Primrose as well because I feel like her lip is a little bit rosy. And I'm literally just filling in the lip because I used a lipstick yesterday and I did not like the look. I feel like it was not what she had going on. Add a little bit of shimmer to the lip. I'm going to put a little bit of Aquaphor. Not shimmer, a little bit of like moist. Ew. Y'all know what I'm saying. Don't even make me say it again. Okay, you guys, I think this is the finished look. Feels similar to the photo. I love it. I love the orange. Let me just pull up the photo. I'll take my own photo. We can compare. But it was pretty simple to do. And I hope you guys enjoyed it. If there's something else you guys want me to do or want to see, I love recreating these looks. I'm not a professional, but it is so much fun to show you what I've learned over the past few years modeling. So if there's anything else you guys want to see, please feel free to write it in the comments. And if you have any opinions or advice, I'd also love to hear that from you. So thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you guys next time.